my scrappy friends. So I have a new day for you in my December daily. And I am working on day 9 right now. And I am going to do part of day 10, though I've somehow lost the video for the rest of my second half of day 10. So I will apologize for that. I've been doing so many videos that I think I forget to like delete out of the already deleted bin in pictures. So I am using that chevron over top or underneath, and I had wished I had thought a little bit more about it because I wanted that blue to peek out because I knew I was going to be using some, like I wanted to have some of that color in there. And in the end, you really can't see much of it. And these card pockets are really weird. So I had a hard time figuring out how big I needed it to be and still fit. And in the end, with the pop dots and everything that I add, it just like slides out really easily. But anyway, it is what it is. And it turned out really nice. I used that Echo Park thing that says stockings and a little card from, I think that's October Afternoon, and it says Dear Santa. And then I used some Fancy Pants little die cut pieces like that Santa. I thought that would be really cute. And it looks really cute on that Fancy Pants advertisement paper on the background. It makes it look vintagey without being too vintage. And that day, I had taken a picture of all our stockings in a row where we have our stockings hung up. So I believe that's what I'm going to use for my picture for that day because Tuesday, we didn't really do much except for school. So I'm trying to, on the days that we don't do much, use pictures of like Christmassy things or, you know, stuff like that. Or like stories of like old Christmas stories or something like that. That's kind of what my thought process is. I don't journal because at this point I'm pretty sure what a picture I'm going to use. But if I don't, I want to be able to switch it up when I'm able to print all my pictures out. So that right there is a piece from, a leftover piece from Ellie Studios. They have like a whole bunch of banners and stuff on their cut apart sheet. So here we go. I'm working on the second pocket and I pick out that October Afternoon paper with all the dots. It's really cute. It's not Christmassy and Christmassy all at the same time. And I'm just going to edge this, keep it really simple because I'm pretty sure that's probably where my picture is going to go. And I'm going to use some washi tape. I probably won't use a whole by four by six. I'll probably make it like a 4x4 or something. So here I'm trying to fit everything in and I realize that my card doesn't quite fit because I used the ho 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 on pop dots and my number 9. So I'm figuring out if I need to move my cards around, and I realize, no, I'm just going to put them together so they don't, at least they slide together. So hopefully that works. There's no change in it now. They're stuck together with ATG. And as you can see, I'm having a hard time getting them in and out. I really should have thought about the fact that I was probably going to use some kind of dimensional. So here is part of day 10, and this is the only card that I have. Is this, and this is Teresa Collins. Oh my gosh, I can't talk. It might have something to do with that I'm doing a whole bunch of voiceovers all at the same time. Get them all done. I really like the wood grain in this, and I love that you can see the nails. So I edge that, make sure it fits since I cut it all on my own. And so here I'm looking through, and I think about using that Webster's Page card. It's really, really pretty. It's a nice wood grain and that Ellie Studio tag with the red, but in the end, I don't use it because I don't want to cover up all of the nails. Now that will be interesting of how I want do that page when it goes to put my picture up. I know, let's see, actually on the 10th I didn't take any pictures, so I will probably do mostly journaling, and I don't know. I might stick a small picture or something on there. So I do cut a banner out of that October afternoon. And then I decide this is a good place to use that reindeer head for putting my number on. And I do use a little bit of that glue. And because it's like embossed or something, it's really difficult for that tape to like stick on. So I end up using the glossy accents and I put a little bit more underneath the antlers so they don't rip, because that is really, really thin. I'm not sure who made those. Those were in a swag bag by Paper Issues. And I think this is about it. I think this is when my something, like, it must have cut off. But that's pretty much it for that card. And then I will show you close-ups of the other card that I made. So I really liked how those both turned out. So there's just the plain card. My ho 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 stocking card. I love how that turned out. It turned out so cute with the Santa and the pop. Everything that's pop dotted, it really looks really cute. And so there's that card, and you can see the nail holes in that gold foil. It's so pretty. And then, so this is the other card that I put on, and I used chipboard pieces. So thank you guys for listening and watching, and I'll see you later. Bye.